the question is, okay, are we done? No, we're not done, because we need to get to the bottom of this. We need to assign all 10 digits, right? And in a, at least in the analysis of digits, of HTS digits 5, 6, 7, and 8, we have a special rule, which is called GRI 6, General Rule of Interpretation 6, which really tells us that, look, there is no need to reinvent the wheel again. Use those rules in the context of other, in the context of the subheading analysis. But with one caveat, if you're going to use those rules, you must do them in proper order. In the context of classification tables, the proper order means the level. What do I mean by level? Here we have level 1, then we have level 2, then we have level 3. So we cannot compare infant walkers with upholstered. We have first to say, is it a seat? Then, is it upholstered or not upholstered? And only then we can ask ourselves the question of whether it's a high chair, bouncer, swing, stationary, other household or other, right? We cannot venture in the question of outdoor or not outdoor until we figure out it's upholstered or not upholstered. And only then we can compare this subheadings. In other words, the apply rules 1 through 3, but adhere to the same level comparison. With headings, we didn't need to do that because headings were all at the same level. All headings, first four, they're all at the same level. They start with the headings, right? All the chapters, they start with the heading. So there was no need, really need to say, oh, you must compare this heading to that heading at the same level. It's just extra words. However, once we get to the subheading, we start to deal with hierarchy. And because we have hierarchy here, this hierarchy must, we must adhere to the rules of hierarchy. We must do the first level, then the second level, then the third level in the order received. In other words, what GRI 6 says is that classification of goods in subheadings shall be determined to the terms of subheadings so long as the subheadings are at the same level, are comparable. So stick to the same level analysis. And of course, you have chapter subchapter notes, which is GRI 1. You have heading and subheading notes also. Those are all legally binding. So it's a must. Here is one example that I put out. So we have animals. Heading is 0106. Before we figure, we can ask a question, is it a fox or is it a dog? We first of all have to determine, is it a mammal, is it a reptile, or is it a bird? Because this is a breakdown. If it's a crocodile, we do not try to figure out under the mammal section, right? We go to the reptiles. If it's a bird, we do not go to the mammals, right? So first question is it a mammal, a reptile, or a bird? Once we figure out, let's say it's a mammal, our next question will be at the same level, subheading, right? We go to the next level. The next level deals with the question, is it a primate or is it not a primate, meaning other? All right, so we know it's a mammal, yes. We know it's, let's say, it's not a primate. All right? It's not a primate. Then our next question is it a fox or is it not a fox? All right, so you say, let's say it's not a fox. So then our next question would be, is it a dog or is it not a dog? And if it's not a dog, then this would be 01061991 95 would be your classification choice. So really, it's kind of like a check system where you have to go through step-by-step analysis. So GRI 6 is all about asking questions at this level. Once you figured it out, you go to the next level, you go to the next level, and you go to the next level until you hit the 10-digit bottom. Another example is with a lamp. So picture a lamp. Let's say it's an ornamental lighting fixture which you put in your home, in your room. And it is comprised of two types of components. There are metal components and there are plastic components. And all are important components. So plastic components are important because they serve ornamental purpose. Let's say this is plastic all surrounding, right? Like acrylic. But the metal components are also important because without metal components, the lamp would not function. You need hinges, you need the housing you need the electrical sockets, electrical connections to make the light function. So metal is important for utilitarian purposes. Plastic is important for aesthetic purposes. And you really cannot compare two because those two purposes are really important. If you have something which looks really ugly, you probably would not buy it, even if it's a lamp. So aesthetic appearance is extremely important if you're going to try to sell a product. So how do you analyze this? Well, the analysis takes you from GRI 1 quickly to GRI 6 to chapter 95. Chapter 94, 9405. 9405 heading provides for lamps which are have a permanently fixed light source, not elsewhere specified or included. So this is the correct provision, okay? This is it. Now, this is as far as you got. This is GRI 1. You got there, right? Now you go to the subheading analysis at the GRI, and the only rule you have for that is GRI 6. You have GRI 6. So here, you have to ask yourself a question. Is it an electric ceiling lightning fitting, or is it something such as electric desk, table, or bedside or floor standing lamp, like torchier?